Hello guys, and welcome back to my channel.
And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
So today's video is something that I'm super excited for, and that is my fall Project Use It Up introduction. So as you can see, I've donned my fall colors, still in a tank top though, because it is still 98 degrees here in Houston. But I am so ready for the fall Project Use It Up. I do still have a few not so fallish items just because I'm not like super into the pumpkin and things mood yet. Not quite yet, not while it's still hot outside, but I do have a few things that I am incorporating that are also from the new fall stuff, so I'm super excited to show you guys what I'm going to be working on for the next few months. And so this project is starting on September 1st, and it will be rolling until, let's say, November 1st. I'm not quite sure if by then I will have a bunch of Christmas stuff already, so we'll just have to play it by ear, but I want to say that I'll finish it like October 31st, like finish it on Halloween and then start Christmas on November 1st, but we shall see. It might end up being more like midway through November, but I will let you guys know whenever that happens. But today is the introduction of the fall project, so let's go ahead and get on into it. So for the first time, I actually kind of grouped things by scent, and I usually don't do that. I usually just do by product, but we're gonna go by scent today instead. So the first thing I'm actually super excited to incorporate, because it's pretty new to my collection, and that is the OGX Coffee and Coconut Scrub and Wash. So if you are new to the hygiene community, you may not know about this, but everybody else definitely knows about it. I'm gonna go ahead and mark it while I'm talking about it, but it smells so delicious. It literally just smells like coffee. I've been loving it in the shower. It has like a perfect mixture of coffee and a little bit of coconut. I'm not the biggest coconut fan, but this is like a perfect amount. It has a little bit of a texture like a scrub to it, but I wouldn't really consider it a scrub. It's not really that scrubby. So, but this actually definitely reminded me of Vanilla Mocha Cafe from last year. And if you guys don't know, this is a scent last year. The scent notes aren't on the back, but I'll go ahead and put the scent notes down here. But I had this in every single form last year, actually, except for the body cream. I had this in the mist, in the lotion, in the shower gel, and in the scrub. And it was actually called Cafe au lait, or coffee and cream. Yeah, it was coffee and cream scrub. It was so delicious. It smelled like I was brewing coffee in the bathroom when I used it, and I just absolutely loved it. So these two I will definitely be pairing together. And I've actually been loving this with my morning showers. So sometimes I will wake up early and work out in the morning and then use this. It's like literally a motivator for me to get up in the morning. So I've been loving it, and I will pair it with the Vanilla Mocha Cafe spray, and I'm gonna go ahead and mark where I'm at with that. So I am about right here on the spray, and I marked it on the black part, so of course you can't see, but I do really love the spray. It is kind of more chocolatey than it is coffee-y, because I think the mocha is really the biggest factor in this, but I loved this last year, and so I'm really looking forward to using it this year. It's definitely more of like a intro to fall scent and like a fall scent, so I'm kind of incorporating this because it's kind of like going to be my first taste of fall. The next scent family is Strawberry Pound Cake. So I did have the lotion of this in my summer project, so I'm just going to carry it over because I just want to keep finishing it up. I'm right here so far, so I'm right here on the back. The scent notes are fresh strawberries, golden shortcake, and whipped cream, so I'm gonna try and keep finishing this up. And then along with it, I do have the Strawberry Pound Cake Moisturizing Body Wash, and I am at 10.9 ounces currently. Even though this is a 10 fluid ounce bottle, that doesn't mean the weight of it is 10 ounces. When I had first bought it, I measured it on a scale. My mom has one of those like shipping scales, and it was 13 ounces when I first got it. And now it's down to 10.9 ounces. So I'm starting it out in the fall project at 10.9 ounces. So I'll be using these two together. And then the last scent family is going to be Whipped Vanilla Chiffon. So I did pick this up actually this past summer, and I've been liking it. I have used it a little bit, both the mist and the body lotion. So I am gonna go ahead and mark where it's at right now. But I really want to get some use out of this because I just want to tell if I like actually love it or not. And also, I feel like this is a really good intro to fall scent. It is wild vanilla bean, sponge sugar, and white peach blossom. I feel like this is also a good year-round scent, but it's like very vanilla-y and warm, and I can see this being a really nice relaxing scent to use at nighttime And then for the spray, I'll go ahead and mark it. So we're starting out right about here. I don't necessarily want to finish up the spray, but I do want to get some progress on it just so I can, you know, actually be using stuff in my collection. Okay, and everything else is just oddball. There's no correlation to any of this. So the first thing is the Twilight Woods Diamond Shimmer Mist. So I found this actually at this past SAS, and I want to say it was like $2 or something. I know it was 75% off, and it is actually $14.58, and this is from 2020, just by the way. But I hadn't really ever smelled Twilight Woods, nor was I ever interested in it before, but I really do like it. And it's like actually kind of a sophisticated scent. So I can definitely see myself using this Diamond Shimmer Mist like all over my body whenever I go on like date night, or like we go out to a nice place or something, and be using this as like my nice fancier scent. So that's what I'm definitely gonna be using Twilight Woods for. And I'm just excited to get some use out of it. I've never actually had a Diamond Shimmer Mist before. Maybe I had one in like high school, but I don't remember it. So this will be my first experience with a Diamond Shimmer Mist, so I'll let you know how it goes, but I'm very excited to start using it. And the last full-size item is the Blackberries and Basil Shower Gel. So I did actually have this in my summer project, and I'm just gonna roll it over to this one too. The scent notes are fresh blackberry, pink pomelo, sweet basil, and jasmine petals. I've been loving this. It's nice and fresh and fruity. It's also, I think, a really good transition to fall scent. It smells so yummy. It's just nice and fresh, and I've actually also been loving this for after workouts if I work out in the evening. It's just like a nice refreshing kind of scent. Really been loving it. And then I do have a few minis. So the first one is Honey Wildflower in the Fine Fragrance Mist, and this is just like the cutest little bottle. I don't have the scent notes, so I'll put them down here, but I do want to use this and see if I actually like it so I can purchase more things in this collection if I do. So I just want to start using it and seeing how I feel about it. It's a little more floral than I usually go for. So I want to see if I actually like it, because if I don't, then I'm going to return it or exchange it. But I'm going to go ahead and start using it. And so it is right about here. I've used it a few times already, but I'm just going to try it and see if I like it. And then the next body care mini is Pinkberry Clouds in the Body Cream. I actually used this for the first time this weekend, and I've really been enjoying it. It definitely reminds me of Pink Velvet Cupcake. It's pretty much the same thing, except with maybe a little more marshmallow, but it smells amazing. The scent notes I don't have, so sadly they are not on the bottle, but it smells really amazing. Really looking forward to using it. I think I'll have it used up within the next month, just because it is a mini. And I just realized I don't actually have any body creams in this project so far, but I will be putting some in. I actually have a white pumpkin and chai that I'm waiting to use until it actually gets cold, so I will be putting that in. But for now, this will be the only body cream, which is fine because I actually enjoy body lotions a little bit more when it's super hot outside, because I don't have to wait so long for them to sink in. But yeah, we'll be using this one. And I am actually putting in the Pink Velvet Cupcake Fine Fragrance Mist. I actually forgot it at work, so I'm gonna insert some footage of where it's at right now, but I've had that in all my Project Use It Ups since the beginning of 2021, maybe even before that. Actually, I think I started it in the fall of last year. So I will be continuing to use that. I just want to finish it up. I want to get it out of my collection, but I absolutely love that scent. Don't get me wrong. I will be repurchasing it once I finish it, but I will be aiming to finish that up. And then kind of a random thing, and I usually don't do this, but I'm going to put in a perfume, and this is Victoria's Secret Tease Heartbreaker. It's not that I don't like this perfume, but I want to see how much progress I can get if I actually focus on it. So this is just a rollerball of it, but I will go ahead and mark where I'm at, and I'm just going to challenge myself to kind of bring this with me everywhere and try and use it as much as I can and just see how much progress I can get, so I can start kind of tracking how much perfume I would typically use. So I will start using this guy. And then something I'm really excited about putting in the project this go round, which I've never done before, is actually body scrubs. So I'm going to put in two into the project. The first one is the Onyx Bathhouse Foaming Body Scrub in Toasted Marshmallow. So this one I got at TJ Maxx. I think I took the sticker off, but I'm pretty sure it was $7.99. And this is what the packaging looks like. It is the toasted marshmallow version. Really, really cute. Basically has a s'mores on the front. I have used it a few times already. This is the thickest scrub I've ever used in my life. So definitely be careful if you don't like thick scrubs, but here's kind of what it looks like. I'm gonna keep the film on mine though, just in case I don't want it to get super messy, but it's like super thick. It's a very thick consistency, and then you get it wet and it turns foaming. It's really fun to use. So I've been enjoying it. It basically just smells like sugar to me. I don't know if it smells like toasted marshmallow, but I definitely do get sugar, and it has honey extract. You know what? I do smell the honey a little bit. But I do want to go ahead and focus on using this up because I did buy 3 body scrubs at once. So I need to like actually be actively using them. So the second one I'm putting in is the Dove Exfoliating Body Polish in the Crushed Macadamia and Rice Milk version. And this is a medium exfoliator. I've actually been loving this so much. So what I used to do with body scrubs in the shower, and I used to use only exclusively Bath & Body Works ones, is I would only use them once a week and I would only shave once a week. But I have kind of been shaving a little more often just because it's the summer and because I have a boyfriend, so I'm shaving my legs and everything. So I'll only use this one once a week since it's super exfoliating and like kind of harsh, honestly. And then this one I'll use maybe 2 times a week or 1 time a week in between that. So I've been really loving it. Here's my progress so far. Like, I've literally had it for probably 2 weeks and I've already used that much of it. So I'm loving this so much, and it smells, I wouldn't say it actually has like a crazy smell. It just kind of smells like bath care. Like, it just smells like soap. I don't know. It's like really relaxing though, and very simple, and I love the texture of it. It's like super smooth and very gentle, and I feel like this is like a really good almost everyday kind of body scrub. You could probably use this every single day and be totally fine, but I'm not gonna use it every day, maybe every other day. But yeah, I've been absolutely loving this one. I don't think this will be lasting very long in my collection, and I definitely will be repurchasing them, and probably only the medium exfoliator, or probably lighter maybe. So let me know down below if you have some Dove body polish recommendations. Like, let me know your favorite flavor, scent, whatever, and where you get them, because I've only ever seen 4 different types at Target. So yeah, let me know if there's different scents at different places. I don't know, I'm kind of new to the body scrub game, non-Bath & Body Works body scrubs, that is. So I don't know too much about those, but let me know down below if you know. And then the last 2 things that I'm incorporating are hand creams. So if you guys don't know, I think I go through 1 hand cream every 2 weeks. So the first one I'm putting in, I'm actually bringing over from the summer, is the Burt's Bees hand cream. This is honey and grape seed. I do like this formula a lot. It smells basically just like honey, and I feel like it would be a good transitional scent actually. So been using this already. It's pretty much like kind of halfway used, I would say. So it won't take me long to finish that one. And then the second one I'm putting in is the Bath & Body Works Pumpkin Cupcake hand cream, which I actually just picked up with my birthday reward at Bath & Body Works. So really excited for this one. It's definitely like pumpkin spice. It smells so good. I'm really looking forward to using this. So this would be like the only pumpkin thing that I'm putting in the project so far, but I'm kind of okay with it because I'm really not into the pumpkin just yet. But this is pretty much unused, so starting it off unused in the project. So that's everything for my fall Project Use It Up intro. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know down below. Okay, question 1, have you started using fall body care, or are you like me and you're a little bit like not ready for it? That's question number 1. And question number 2, what are you most looking forward to using in the fall? I think, honestly, what am I most looking forward to? I guess this coffee one, but I wouldn't even say that that's like super fall-y, but this coffee combination is going to be really yummy. I'm also like super looking forward to when it's colder and using white pumpkin and chai finally. So very excited for that. I do actually have a pumpkin cupcake lotion coming in the mail, so I'm pretty excited to try that out and see how that goes. But yeah, that's everything for this video. I hope that you guys enjoyed. If you did, like, comment, and subscribe down below. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!